Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Swordaz here. Today I'm going to cover a topic that is actually going to be extremely difficult to convey. It'll require patience through the video, but by the end, I hope I can paint a clear picture on 500 versus 1000 polling rate. My guides, I generally try to tailor for both PC and console in terms of concept, but this one's going to be strictly about mice polling rate. Next week, I'm going to cover monitor refresh rate, and it'll be a beneficial topic for both PC and console peeps alike. So let's get into it. 500 versus 1000 polling rate, which is better? I'm going to answer quickly and say on a very technical basis, you can claim 1000 polling rate is actually mathematically better. So yes, yay, 1000 polling rate is better. But for now, a more complex and in-depth answer is that it really depends on the game and also the individual. So now we have an answer of neither. This is where the fun begins. And while you're watching the video and searching endlessly through YouTube for a dumb answer like this, because trust me, I've looked myself. What I'm going to do is attempt to explain in this video the reason why pros utilize 500 polling rate and why other pros utilize 1000. After my own personal experience of practicing and playing it both for hundreds of hours, I hope to give a pretty in-depth explanation. I've seen many YouTube videos explaining this topic, and visually, unless you have a camera that can record an extremely high frame rate, it's going to be really hard to showcase. And even if I had that really expensive camera, something that you inherently see, it's going to be really, really minor in difference. Because also, even the way you handle the mouse and control you have is also going to have an impact on what you see visually. So what I'm going to cover in terms of polling rate, I'm going to cover what really is polling rate of a mouse, the difference in feel, then finally the theory behind choosing one or the other. Polling rate on a mouse is something that sends a refresh on where the location of the mouse is on the mouse pad and how much data the sensor is essentially picking up. If you have a 500 polling rate, then every 2 milliseconds it sends an update to your computer. If it is 1000 polling rate, then it is 1 millisecond being sent to your computer or CPU. You get the picture, right? Polling rate can change based on the game because the sources utilized in the game and CPU usage, so coding can be a major factor. Modern hardware has less of an issue when it comes to receiving updates from the mouse, but some games, even if you select 1000 polling rate, can really fluctuate between even 700 to 1000 and not be a clean, consistent 1000. Even some mice have this issue depending on the sensor and the build quality of the mouse. It is why some do not advertise 1000 polling rate, because they realistically cannot hit that consistent standard. But again, most modern day sensors do not really have this issue. Those that have really bad CPUs back in the day would prefer utilizing 500 polling because it gave them extra resources to the game to obtain more consistent and higher frame rates depending on the scene. It was really minor, but at a competitive level, it did make a difference. But I want to reiterate that modern hardware has less of an issue. So that leaves people ask, why the heck do pros still use 500 polling? When they really try to inch out every performance, why not go from 2 milliseconds to 1 millisecond? It is clear, yes, 500 updates less than 1000, right? So yeah, true. Let's talk about the feel now, so then we can get more in depth. The feel is also really a placebo effect, because you need a massive amount of time to really tell the difference on feeling the sensor and the mouse it provides, because there's a lot of different factors. Even the shape of the mouse can really feel different in terms of just control. These are words that are best to describe 500 versus 1000 polling rate. 1000 polling rate feels more floaty, responsive, and alive. Now for 500 polling, it feels sharper, heavier in some cases, and more consistent. So let's break this down further. Because 1000 polling rate is so alive, it actually does track more of what is going on. So if you happen to have those hand jitters, or your aim is unsure on something, then perhaps moving to 500 polling rate can help smooth things out for your aim. But it's crucial for sniping to have that minimal movement to pick up depending on your sensitivity. When you're massively zoomed in and making small movements, the movements in between can really be important for 1000 polling rate. Now, let's break down 500 polling. Because not every single movement is picked up in theory, then you can manage your shot more. You remove the feeling of it feeling alive or too floaty. It has a sharp feeling that can give that consistency. It can give the illusion that it feels heavier because less is being technically tracked. Remember the 1 millisecond update versus the 2 millisecond. The overall difference to an average person is honestly extremely minimal, but it takes hundreds of hours to really feel the difference. Now for a pro's perspective, some pros, because they have utilized 500 polling rate for such a massive portion of their gaming career, they just stick with 500 polling. Why switch what isn't broken? 1000 polling gives that floating sensation, just some people don't like it. They really did this for consistent frames, but now you can view it for more consistent gameplay. As I mentioned prior, there is a downside for zoomed in sniper shots of not tracking every movement for sniping. Rocket Jump Ninja did a great explanation on this when you are zoomed in. The issue is that everyone controls a mouse differently, either with sharper movement or more fluid movement. So you cannot just simply showcase this on screen, because obviously, as we discussed before, the results will differ depending on the person. What is consistent is the overall sensation of the movements. I really recommend for you, as the viewer, to go into a sterile environment, and either it be a game or a place that you feel comfortable with, like even an empty server or an aim trainer, to feel it what feels best for you. I actually went back from 1,000 to 500, then went back to 1,000 pulling rate. So I'm going to explain my journey of what I did. My journey, I found that my aim did have a lot of jitters in it. I would overshoot and then I would jitter and it would pick up everything far in between. When I switched to 500, it kind of smoothed out my aim and gave me a little more consistency that I was craving. But then over time, as I improved, I wanted that 1,000 pulling rate feeling back because I wanted to feel the movements in between because I learned how to have that control. It just becomes a visual thing and more of a feel. The last thing I want to hit on is that the rumor that 1,000 pulling rate feels worse on 60 hertz and obviously feels better on higher hertz monitor. This depends on your taste. I tested both and it's really hard to distinguish which is worse. I think it might depend on the refresh rate of the game and the CPU usage that people are feeling. If CPU usage is too high, then obviously 1,000 pulling rate is going to be a problem. Dropping it will prove to be better in some cases. This is why I go back to pros sticking to 500. No matter the scene, it feels consistent, right? I really hope you learned a lot through this video. I feel based on every video on YouTube, this really covers pulling rate the best way possible. Because it is a sensation, and even the exact science providing which is better, some go opposite of that reasoning. Because it is a sensation that you're feeling. And even with the exact science of saying 1,000 pulling rate is technically better, pros still go the opposite and they provide different reasons for it, obviously as we explained prior. So hit me up in the comment section on your thoughts. What pulling rate do you use and why? Did you go from 1,000 to 500 or did you go opposite from 500 to 1,000? Does your reasoning match what I explained? Let me know and we'll do a follow-up video and go more in depth on this. Thank you so much for watching guys and I'll see you all next time.